The second cycle time measuring tool is complete. I'll show you its improvements. Hi, this is Mike Negami, rinsing my black belt. More than a year ago, I published a video and template about cycle time and production labeling. Many viewers gave me comments and suggestions about the template. I really appreciate it. So now, I've improved the cycle time measuring tool template. Since some issues have been fixed and an improvement to expand its application has been added, I would like to introduce those points today. If you haven't watched the previous video, please click on the link above and learn the basics of cycle time and production labeling first. This is the last version of the template. Due to the design layout, it couldn't be used for a process with more than 10 steps. In addition, I received many requests for a function that could increase the number of attempts. Therefore, I changed the layout like this so that you can increase the numbers of both steps and attempts as many as you need. Click on this yellow cell saying add more steps in the instructions. Then Excel will ask you how many steps you need. Let's say enter 15 and click OK. Then additional necessary steps will be automatically added. Type the names of your process steps in this row. You can increase the number of attempts as well with the next add more attempts button. Also, as you are measuring, when the remaining lines become fewer, Excel automatically adds lines. It's very convenient. In the previous version, you could measure only operation times. However, I've received requests to be able to record completion times. So now you can select operation duration or completion time for the recording format. When you choose completion times will be recorded. The following is a major improvement. In the last version, you could measure your process time linearly, but it's more useful if you can simultaneously measure multiple operators or process lines and compare their results easily. Now you can do that in the new version. Let's look at a completed chart first. The horizontal axis represents the operators and the vertical axis represents the operation time. The length of the bar colors represents the completion times of each step. With this, we can intuitively understand how much time differences there are between operators and process steps. Let's try making one right now. Multiple simultaneous measurement has been added to the measuring method option here. Select it. For the recording format, I'll select operation duration. With the other measuring method, we just have attempt 1, attempt 2 here. For this method, this column is for operators or process lines. You may want to put their names there. When the first operator starts their process step, double-click on the operator's line in the table. Then the start time will be recorded here, and you'll see an orange highlight line. As you click a cell in the table, the highlight moves accordingly. When another operator starts their first process step, select the operator and click the next button, then his start time appears. Therefore, the times in the first column are all of their start times. After that, when an operator finishes each process step, select the operator and click the next button to record the time. Repeat this until all operators have completed all the steps. Then you can click the Stop Recording button. With this measuring method, you can also choose completion time here. This is the result of using completion time. It's suitable for improving an operation that has specific work schedule times. In order to prepare for the next round of measuring, you can date the previous data manually, or click this Save and Clear button to copy the sheet and prepare for the next session. This improved version is very useful, and I use this tool to measure my customers' waiting times in my work. This also seems to work well for race competitions and games. Please share with us what kind of measurements you use this tool for in the comment sections below. Thank you very much for viewing. Please click the subscribe button. Also, click and watch my other related videos. Thanks.